Uncle, it is nice to be here. I'm sure that you have a story to tell me.
Yes, my dear. I have a story to tell you today. It is about another companion of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Abdullah bin Maktum radhiyallahu ta'ala anhu.
Uncle, please go ahead. I am so excited to hear the story.
Sure. Story of Abdullah bin Maktum. Abdullah bin Maktum radhiyallahu ta'ala anhu was the companion of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was blind by birth. He was also known as Amr bin Maktum, as well as Amr bin Qais. His mother's name was Atika, and her surname was Maktum, which meant mother of the blind. People call her that name because she gave birth to a blind child. He was the cousin of the Prophet's first wife, Khadija radhiyallahu ta'ala anha. Abdullah bin Maktum was amongst the first converts to Islam. He loved his religion and would walk his way to the masjid 5 times a day to offer his obligatory prayers. Once the Prophet took him and Musab bin Umair radhiyallahu ta'ala anhu to Medina, they were interested with the task of teaching Quran to the inhabitants before the hijrah took place. Abdullah radhiyallahu ta'ala anhu and Bilal bin Rabah radhiyallahu ta'ala anhu were chosen as muazzins in Medina by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had to leave Medina for participating in battles, and he gave Abdullah radhiyallahu ta'ala anhu the responsibility of leading the prayers. Abdullah radhiyallahu ta'ala anhu witnessed the rise of Islam in Makkah. He was amongst the first to accept Islam. He suffered with his brothers when the Muslims were persecuted. Abdullah bin Maktum radhiyallahu ta'ala anhu was very much devoted to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was so keen to memorize the Quran that he would not miss any opportunity to achieve his heart's desire. His sense of urgency and his insistence was sometimes irritating to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as well. Once, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was in a meeting with a group of Persian nobles, and he was trying to convince them to become Muslims. He was talking with them and explaining them about Islam and the Holy Quran. The Prophet wished that they would respond positively to him and accept Islam, or at least call off their persecution of his companions. During those days, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's and sahabas were experiencing a lot of trouble from the Persians. That's why this meeting was so important to him, and he wanted no one to disturb him. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was seriously engaged in the conversation, Abdullah radhiyallahu ta'ala anhu walked in and asked him to read a verse from the Quran. He said, "O Messenger of God, teach me from what God has taught you." The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam frowned and turned away from him. He then turned his attention to the Persians and continued with their conversation. The Prophet knew that if they accepted Islam, they would bring greatness to the religion and strengthen his mission. He did not want to be disturbed and was earnestly trying to convince them. Once the Prophet had finished speaking with them, he left the room. But as soon as he left the room, he was suddenly blinded partially, and his head began to throb violently. At this point, a revelation came from Allah to the Prophet. It was in relation to this incident that Allah revealed the 80th Surah Abasa, rebuking the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and commanding him to give priority and attention to the concerns of the true believers of Islam, like Abdullah bin Maktum radhiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Do you want me to recite Surah 80th for you?
Sure, uncle.
He frowned and turned away when the blind man approached him. Yet, for all you knew, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he might perhaps have grown in purity or have been reminded of the truth and helped by this reminder. Now, as for him who believes himself to be self-sufficient, to him you gave your whole attention, although you're not accountable for his failure to attain to purity. But as for him who came unto you full of eagerness and in awe of God, him did you disregard? This is but a reminder, and so whoever is willing may remember him in the light of his revelations, blessed with dignity, lofty and pure, born by the hands of the messengers, noble and most virtuous. These are the 16 verses which were revealed to the noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam about Abdullah bin Maktum radiallahu ta'ala anhu. 16 verses that have continued to be recited from that time till today and shall continue to be recited. From that day, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to honor Abdullah bin Maktum radiallahu ta'ala anhu and give him the utmost respect. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam never ceased to be generous with Abdullah bin Maktum radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He took care to ask him about his affairs, to fulfill his needs, and took him into his counsel whenever he approached. The situation of the Muslims was very tough those days. The Prophet and the companions had to face the attack of the enemies every other day. When the enemies intensified their persecution, Allah gave them permission to emigrate. Abdullah and Mus'ab bin Umair radiallahu ta'ala anhu were the first of the companions to reach Medina. As soon as they reached Yasrib, Abdullah radiallahu ta'ala anhu and Mus'ab bin Umair radiallahu ta'ala anhu began talking to the people, read Quran to them and taught them the religion of Allah. Soon after the battle of Badr, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam received a revelation from God raising the status of the Mujahideen and preferring them over the Qaideen, those who remain inactive at home. This was in order to encourage the Mujahid even further and to help the Qaid to give up their inactivity. This revelation affected bin Maktum deeply. Being a blind man, he was excluded from the battles and he stayed home mostly. In spite of being excused from battle, the soul of Abdullah bin Maktum radiallahu ta'ala anhu refused to be content with staying among those who remained at home while there was a battle going on. He decided to actively involve in all campaigns of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was so eager to join in the battlefield. One day, he fixed a role for himself in the battlefield. He then said, "Give me the flag and place me on a horse between the two rows. I will carry it for you and protect it, for I am blind and cannot run away." What he implied here was that he would never run away because of fear, and he will be loyal to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam until his last breath. In the 14th year after the Hijrah, Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu led a battle against the Persians and won the battle. He then wrote to his governors, "Send anyone with a weapon or a horse or who can offer any form of help to me." Crowds of Muslims from every direction responded to Umar's call and traveled to Medina. Among them were the blind Mujahid Abdullah bin Maktum. He had vowed to carry and protect the rights of the Muslims or be killed in the process. The forces met and engaged in battle for 3 days. The fighting was among the most fierce and bitter in the history of the Muslim conquests. On the third day, the Muslims achieved a mighty victory as one of the greatest empires in the world collapsed and one of the most secure thrones fell. The price of this clear victory was hundreds of martyrs. Among them was Abdullah bin Maktum. He was found dead in the battlefield, still holding the flag in his arms. He was a true believer of Allah who feared nothing. He was a great inspiration to those who were physically challenged, who thought that they could not achieve anything in their life. So did you like the story of Abdullah bin Maktum radiallahu ta'ala anhu?
MashaAllah, that was great, Uncle Yusuf. I loved the story very much. He was a great man with great love towards the Prophet, the Holy Quran and the religion.
Okay, it is time to go home. Come on, let us walk home.